am Amber Hart, helping with the North Nodaway After Prom, and Edward Wonder, that hypnotist, just performed at our After Prom, and he was amazing. The kids thoroughly enjoyed him. It took about, you know, an hour and a half, and it helped the kids kind of get energized. I liked it because it gives the kids a chance to be themselves when they might not want to be themselves in front of their peers. So that's one of the reasons I like going to a hypnotist.
Okay, good enough for me. Thank you.
When I wanted to go back into hypnosis, all I have to do is say 1, 2, 3 and sleep and pull on my tie, and you will go back into hypnosis as deeply or deeply than before. Just me, just for the show, you're already ready. 2, 3 and sleep. More focused, relaxed. Give a big round of applause. Go ahead and open your eyes. Go ahead and look at me right up here. Open your eyes. The eyes are just slightly above your ears and in front. Go ahead, 1, 2, 3, open your eyes. And sleep, deeper, more focused, relaxed. Give a big round of applause. Where did this go? So put yourself on that luxury jet. You're in a leather seat. It just forms around you. You're going to have to put on your safety belt, though. Go ahead and buckle your safety belt. Begin your pantomime. Pantomime, putting on that safety belt. That's right. Very good. Very good. We're going to go to that luxury island down in the Caribbean. And we got good news. We get what's called a rolling takeoff. And so what we're going to do, you're going to feel that little bump as we get back away into the jetway. That's right. And then the little push cart lets go and we start to accelerate. We're just going thumpity, 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 down the runway, and we all of a sudden we take that gentle right-hand curve, just like that, and we straighten out and we start to accelerate. Thumpity, 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 thumpity. 50 knots, 75 knots, 80 knots, 90 knots, 110. The front tire comes up off the pavement. Thumpity, 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 thump, and now the back tires come off, and you feel that little whirr and thump as the landing gear comes up into the airplane, and we start to accelerate out, and we take another gentle right-hand curve, and we're going over the Kansas City Stadium down there, and the KU band is down there. I'm sorry, the Missouri Tigers. Let's make the Missouri Tigers be down there. What the hell? And they are spelling out Bon Voyage to you. Go ahead and wave to the band down there. Wave to the Tiger band down there. And they spill out another Have Fun. And that's what we're all about here. We start to accelerate. We're going up. We're at 35,500 feet. And the steward comes by to give you your snacks. The steward comes by, hold your hand out if you'd like to have a snack. There you go. He gives you your snack. Now I'm going to tell you ahead of time, he knows you're all underage. Go ahead and open your snack. There are only 2 pretzels and 3 peanuts in there. This is supposed to be luxury. What is going on? Get his attention. Get the steward's attention. That's right. He comes by. He gives you another sack. He is so sorry. But the craft truck didn't get here in time. This is all we have. But you do have beverages. We won't go through the selection of beverages. Just imagine exotic fruit juices and soda pops and all sorts of stuff like that. There are even non-alcoholic daiquiris in there and things like that. And he gives you your can of beverage, whatever it was you chose. Go ahead and open up that beverage. 1, 2, 3, and psh, all over your face. Oh my goodness. Oh, he feels so sorry. He comes by. He's got a warm washcloth for you. He's got a warm washcloth. Hold on your hand for a warm washcloth. A warm washcloth for you. There you. You know, the peanuts and pretzels are gone, probably half your beverage, but look in front of you, there are 3D goggles. Go ahead and put on those 3D goggles, reach in front of you, grab those 3D goggles, reach in front, there you go. You're almost there. Go ahead and use two hands, go ahead and use two hands. Go ahead and put them on, go ahead and put them on. There you go. 3D goggles, right up here, right up there. There you go. Give them a big round of applause, guys. And we're gonna watch a funny movie. We're gonna watch a funny movie. It's those two mice that pick on that poor stupid cat. Can you guys say, stupid cat? And the camera goes through the little mousy hole, and there are three walls lined up with drawings of what they're going to do to this poor, stupid cat. Say it. That's right. And there are pianos falling from the roof of the house. There's a dog in the yard next door. I don't know what they're going to do to this poor cat. And they goes out and they've tied a rope to the cat's tail. And the cat is just behaving himself, laying in the sun. Oh, and just as he gets the feeling there's something wrong with his tail because his tail isn't waving in the sunlight like it should be, the mouse goes scampering away and the cat looks him back over his shoulder, remember this is 3D, and sees this big old hawser rope tied to his tail, and all of a sudden we cut to the roof of the house, and there's a baby grand piano that the other mouse is pushing off the house, and he goes, and piano keys are flying everywhere right at you, look out, duck, there you go. And then jerks the cat off the lawn, out through the flower garden and through the mail slot into the house, and there is carpeting flying everywhere in 3D across the other piano, up through the chimney, comes flying out into the clouds, back down through the rain spout, around the back of the house, goes back up the rain spout, and plop onto one of the kids' teeter-totters. And that poor cat is covered in coal from the chimney, and he's bruised, and there's little sparkles going around his head. And here comes, look out, the other mouse. And what's that other mouse going to do? He's got a 10-ton Acme anvil. And he pushes it off right onto the far end of the teeter-totter and hits the teeter-totter. Watches that poor, say it with me, into the clouds, through the clouds, back down to earth where that gray bulldog is waiting in the next yard with a fishing net. Catches that cat, and the cat looks at the bulldog. Bulldog looks at the cat, and just smiles, and the cat looks at the bulldog, and the bulldog looks at the cat, and the cat holds up a sign that says, "The End." Give him a big round of applause. Well, we are getting ready to land now, so go ahead and put your 3D goggles away if you would please. We're getting ready to land. And you're going to be greeted here at the airport. And you are being greeted by some of the most handsome young men and women. And they have lays for you. They have lays for you. There you go. And you have twins. one on each side, and they give you a kiss on this cheek, and a kiss on that cheek. And they're surprised, they've never had anybody frown at them before. And gentlemen, these girls have tans that the Missouri girls can't even imagine getting. You think, ladies, that some of your friends work out, these guys are buff beyond your imagination. They are handsome, they are tan, they are good looking. And they are here to give you whatever service you think you might need. They take you to your room. They open the door. They open the door, and did I say room? No, I mean suite. They take you out to the window looking at the lagoon, and they open the doors for you, and you step out onto the patio, and you breathe in that fresh ocean air. Oh, yes. And you see the lagoon down before you. It's a pale, pale blue where that white sand is. And then it gets darker and darker the deeper it goes out to where the reef is that protects this lagoon. And they take you back to the bedroom where your luggage already is. Your luggage is open. And they say, what we'd like you to do, if you want to, is go ahead and we're going to leave and get ready the beach area for you. But you go ahead and change into your beach wear. And then come on down to the beach and we'll have refreshments down there for you. And they say, if there's anything you need, don't forget to mention it. Nothing comes to mind right now. I know a couple of you find that hard to believe, but you're just so overwhelmed at the natural beauty of everything going on here. And you start getting your swimwear out. But if you look over to your right, there's a walk-in closet. And that walk-in closet is filled with swimwear. Ladies, two-piece, one-piece, sarongs. Low-cut, high-cut, natural-cut. Guys, you've got board shorts, you've got Speedos, that's right. There are even man thongs in there. Yes, there are. You know, if you got a variety, reach out and touch that material. Touch that material. It's like a combination of silk and smoke. It is so light and airy, and yet no matter how much you stretch it, you can't see. You can't see through it, even though it is so light. So your modesty is going to be protected, whatever you choose to wear. I'm just going to go down the line. If I'm touching you on the shoulder and talking to you, what kind of swimsuit are you going to wear, young man?
Oh, I'm wearing a beautiful Speedo.
What color Speedo are you going to wear?
Purple.
Purple Speedo, that's right. And miss, what are you going to be wearing today?
Two-piece,
what color?
Pink.
Pink, very good. Sir, what are you going to be wearing?
Nothing.
Swimwear must be worn on the beach at all times. You go ahead and look through. I'll come back to you. What are you choosing to wear?
Two-piece.
Pink? Describe the two-piece suit you're going to wear. For us, if you would please, sir.
American flag.
American flag on the top or the bottom? Very cool. All right, like a crop top on top, and then what kind of shorts on the bottom?
None.
No, swimwear must be worn on the beach at all times. Miss, what kind of swimwear are you going to be wearing?
A two-piece.
Two-piece. Describe it for us.
Floral.
What are you going to be wearing, ma'am?
Two-piece.
Two-piece, what color?
Purple.
More purple, I love purple. Ma'am, what are you going to be wearing today?
A two-piece.
What color?
Blue.
Blue, very good. Sir, what are you going to be wearing?
Speedo.
Very good. What are you going to be wearing?
Two-piece.
And what color for you?
Black.
I want you to show that Speedo off to us, if you would please, sir. What color is it?
He has his plain flag.
What kind of flag?
Spain flag.
From Spain. Very good. Go ahead and stretch that out for us. Show it to us. Or just put it on. That's fine, too. Go ahead and pantomime putting your swimwear on. You don't have to remove any clothes to do this. Just pantomime putting your swimwear on. That's right. And what did you decide to wear?
Speedo.
Speedo. What did you decide to wear?
I think I'm going to have to go with Speedo.
That's fine. That's fine. All right. Let's go on down to the beach. Chaise lounge. Bamboo. Chaise lounges. Go ahead and stretch out. You've got that big old parasol over you. They come by and they give you, we're not going to go into the details, but just hold out your hand, and when I touch on the shoulder, you've got your drink. Some of them are in pineapples, some of them are in coconuts. You're all underage. None of them are alcoholic. They already know better than that. That's right. There you go. And if all you wanted was soda pop, you can have soda pop, but I mean, they've got macadamia nut and virgin pina coladas and daiquiris, and it's just all fresh. You might as well go for the exotic stuff while you're here. That's right. And you hear the waves washing up on the shore. And you feel that sun coming on down, and oh, next to you is some sunscreen. You better put some sunscreen on, because it's pretty pale up there in Missouri in April. So go ahead and get your sunscreen on, if you would please. But there's that one little spot you just can't reach. And here comes your helper, and she, for the guys, just finds that right spot. Ladies, your guy, he just finds that right spot. Your twins, they find one spot here and one spot there. That's right. Right there for you, right there. Right there. Oh, there you go. There you go. Right there. And right there for you, sir. What area of Spain are you from?
Madrid,
beautiful town. I'm jealous of you, I really am. All right, so enjoy the sun, enjoy the waves, but kind of makes you want to go swimming. Now, if in real life you don't swim, don't worry about it. This is in your imagination. I'm going to keep you totally safe. Let's go ahead and go out and go swimming. Let's go ahead and pantomime from your chair that you've gone out into the lagoon and you're swimming. Go ahead and pantomime that you're out there swimming. That's right. And that water just caresses your body. It is gorgeous. Absolutely wonderful. And go ahead and dive down under the water. You can see 25, 30 feet in front of you and back of you all around. Come up for air, come up for air. Go back down. And if you look out ahead of you, you'll see this big old school of silvery little fish like minnows. But they're way out in front of you, way out in front of you. Come on up for air, come on up for air. That's right, down again. And now you're in the middle of the little fishies and they never quite touch you. They're all around you. It's like you're in a silvery cloud, but none of them touches you even once. Come back up for air. That's right, back down, and they're gone. They're gone as fast as they came there. They're gone. Come on up for air. And you see out by the coral of the reef, two fins of dolphins. There are dolphins swimming towards you. Go ahead and dive back down. Can't quite see him yet, but you're looking, you're looking, you're looking. Come back up for air. Back down again, and here comes one of the dolphins. He's swimming towards you. He's swimming towards you, and all of a sudden, bump on your butt. The other one bumped you on your butt, like he's playing tag with you. Come up for air, come up for air, come up for air. And they come up for air, and they are laughing at you. They're like, splash water at those laughing dolphins. Splash water at those laughing dolphins. And they splash water back at you again. Oh, that's right. They splash water back at you again. Oh, my. And now they swim up beside you. They swim up beside you, and they offer you each hand to one of their dorsal fins. And they start bringing you around the lagoon. And they show you the lagoon. They show you where the eel lives. They keep you a safe distance away. The eel comes out, just looks at you. They show you where the sea anemone are, where the clownfish live. So you get to see real clownfish. And they tow you around where there's a sunken sailing ship. And you can still see where the cannon portals used to be. And they're bringing you up for air. Don't worry about that. And it's just so beautiful. After about 45 minutes of being given a tour of the lagoon, they bring you back to the shore and just kind of shrug themselves out of your hand. And they come up in front of you, and they do that little tail dance. They do that little tail dance. They wave their mouth at you. That's right. Wave back at them again. Say bye-bye, dolphins. That's right. Give them a big round of applause, everybody. Go ahead, come back up onto the beach, and there's a big old fluffy towel. Get yourself dry. Get yourself dry. That's right. Go ahead and put on another layer of sunscreen, and again, they get that one special place that you just can't reach. They take care of that for you. And coming down the beach, if you look to your left, there's a star that you recognize. It might be a model, it might be a singer, it might be an actor or an actress, but somebody, a model that you know, an actor, actress, somebody famous, I don't know, it could be a politician for all I know. I know, but hey, they need time off too. If somebody's got some kind of celebrity in mind, raise your hand, raise your hand. Very good. I'm going to pick two or three people here. Put your hand down for now. Except for you, if you would go ahead and open your eyes. Open your eyes. Open your eyes. Hi. Go ahead and stand up. And go ahead. Who is coming down the beach?
Eric Hosmer.
And what do you most like Eric Hosmer for?
His baseball abilities.
Darn right. And have you been able to see him play in person?
Yep.
Pretty good, huh? Wonderful way to spend an afternoon or an evening, isn't it?
Yep.
Strike a pose for Eric. Strike a pose. Get his attention. Get his attention. There you go. You can stand up while you're in hypnosis. And he thinks you're drunk right now, but he's so... comes over because he waved him over and he's used to being a celebrity. And what is Eric wearing on this beach?
His jersey.
Just his jersey, huh?
He has pants on too.
That's okay, that's okay. They can make like long night shirt jerseys. Very cool. He says, you're a baseball fan, I take it.
Yep.
How would you like to have season tickets on the first base dugout side?
What?
Well, tell you what we'll do. I'm going to be watching you tonight. And if you win any of the prizes, I will throw that in.
Really?
Four? Is four tickets enough?
Yeah.
Okay, four tickets. Go ahead and give her a big round of applause. Sit back down. And sleep. There you go. Who else sees a star, a celebrity? Very good. Person I'm touching on the hand right now, open your eyes. Open your eyes. Go ahead and stand up. Who do you see coming down the beach?
The president.
The Trump man himself, huh?
Yeah.
And what is Mr. President Trump wearing?
Something I don't want to see him.
But A, he's Donald Trump. B, he's the president, right?
Yeah.
Do you want to talk to the man?
If he's wearing something different.
Well, then that's not his attention. Fact. Nonchalant. Just nonchalant. Just look around now. He's in back of you. He's in back of you. He's walking away. Walking away. Give him a big round of applause. And sleep. Deeper, more focus. One more person. Who's got a celebrity walking down each? Yes, sir. Person I'm touching on the hand right now. Open your eyes first. Go ahead and stand up. Who do you got walking down the beach?
Emma Watson.
Emma Watson. Her portfolio is so thick.
Hot.
Hot and thick. What's your favorite Emma Watson movie?
All of the Harry Potters.
All of the Harry Potters. And we got to watch her grow up, didn't we? Mm-hmm. She turned into
hot.
She's been in GQ, hasn't she?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Strike a pose for him. And she looks at you and she says, called you? She walks over to you. What would you like to ask Emma Watson?
Do you want my number?
She says, are you from that group from Missouri?
Yeah.
I kind of thought you would be. Bad, Edward, bad. Well, I'll tell you what, I'll be where you're performing tonight and I'll talk to you afterwards. How's that sound?
Very good.
Okay, but you have to impress me.
Oh, I will.
Right. Give a big round of applause. Have a seat. Thank you. Keep your mind focused, relax. Give them all a big round of applause. Let's take you back up to your room where you get ready for casual wear for the evening. Casual wear for the evening. All of the beach wear has been taken out. Now, ladies, you've got cool skirts, you've got dresses, you've got wraparound dresses, you've got blouses, shorts. Men, you've got shorts, you've got pullover shirts, you've got button-down shirts, you've got Hawaiian print, you've got solid color. You've got cotton, you've got that exotic material again, whatever it is you want to wear, but go ahead and pantomime getting into your casual wear for the evening. Just go ahead and pick something out and pantomime putting that on, if you would please. And before we take you to supper or anything like that, we've got a big treat here. Raise your hand if you like roller coasters. Raise your hand if you like roller coasters. Very cool. I've got a couple people that don't like roller coasters. That's fine. As you'll be instructed, all you have to do is step to the other side of your mind and wait for your friends to come back. So you don't have to be scared about this roller coaster at all. However, you know I'm going to keep you safe. So if you want to go on the world's tallest roller coaster, knowing you're going to be safe, you've got that option here today. But you can step across. This is a skit that absolutely rips my throat, so I put it on audio file. You're going to hear my voice change just a little bit, but I'll be right here on stage with you the entire time. Here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, let's go ahead. We're going to go to that
amusement park that I told you about earlier. That's right. You are going to ride the world's tallest roller coaster. It's called the Eighth Wonder of the World. That's right. It's my roller coaster, W-U-N-D-E-R. And we're going to go on that roller coaster. Which makes this so special is it is the world's tallest roller coaster. A multi-gazillionaire went and built this. He wanted the world's tallest, most structurally sound roller coaster. It is 2,500 feet in the air. At its tallest point, you're going to reach speeds of over 120 miles an hour. This is going to be the most awesome ride you've ever experienced. Let's go. Go ahead and get in line. Those of you who want to be at the front, you're at the front. Those at the back, those in the middle, it doesn't matter. It's your roller coaster ride. And for your friends who didn't want to go on the roller coaster ride, you just step across the other line and you go ahead and wait on the other side for your friends to come back. Oh gosh, I do hope your friends come back. That's right. And so now, go ahead, if you would please, bring your safety buckles down over you. Please get them secured safely in place. Go ahead and bring that over your shoulders and down and get them in there, click, just like that. That's right. And now they're going through the safety instructions, how you're not supposed to put your hands outside the car and all that kind of stuff. We know better. We're going to have fun. Our hands are going to go flying in the air. We're going to be screaming and yelling. It's going to be great. And so now here we go, the final safety checks are done. Everybody is secure, your friends are over there waiting for you to come back. Go ahead and here we go, click, bumpity bumpity bum, and here we go, clickety, 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 click, upwards and upwards, yes, that's right. 2,500 feet in the air, this is the world's tallest roller coaster, this is the Eighth Wonder of the World. We're going up and up and up. That's right, Wonder, W-U-N-D-E-R. We are going up and up. This is 2,500 feet in the air. You are now at a 45 degree angle, but your chairs stay in place at all times. Be safe at all times. We are going up 2,500 feet in the air. We're about 500 feet up now. Go ahead, wave to your friends down there. Wave to your friends. There they are. Go ahead and wave back to your friends up on the roller coaster. Go ahead and wave to your friends on the roller coaster. That's right. And here we go. Up, 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 up. We're now 1,500 feet, 1,750 feet. In fact, there are birds flying underneath you. That's how high we are. That's right. There are birds flying underneath you. And we're going up 2,250, and we're getting near the top. We're getting near the top. Clickety, 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 click, and we're hanging, and we're hanging, and we're hanging, and second rise, clickety, clickety, click. We're only going up 1,500 feet this time. That's right. Here are the birds flying next to you here. They're looking at you. You're looking at them. Wave to little birdies. Wave to the little birdies. That's right. And down, 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 down. Here we go through the loop-de-loops. That's right, around and around. And here we come to the rumble strips again. And down a little rumble, through a dark tunnel, out through the other side. Waterfall comes across you, getting you cool and soaked, and oh, it's just great. And here we come to the end. Bumpity bumpity bum, bumpity bumpity bum. And one more loop-de-loop, loop-de-loop. And now here we come. Oh, here we come to the end. Clickety, 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 clip, and boom! There we are. At the end of the Eighth Wonder of the World. That's right. Go ahead. Your friends are there, smile and wave to your friends. They wave back, you made it. Go ahead and unbuckle yourselves and get out on the right-hand side in your mind. That's right, get out on the right-hand side. Give them a big round of applause. A big round of applause. How absolutely wonderful. Now, there were a couple people that said they didn't want to go on the roller coaster. It looked like they changed their mind. Did you enjoy the roller coaster, sir?
Not really.
But you did survive, didn't you?
I
promise. And you, did you enjoy the roller coaster ride?
No.
But you did survive, didn't you?
Did everybody else seem to have fun around you?
Yeah.
By applause, everybody else who was on the roller coaster, did you have fun? By applause. All right, very cool. Give them a round of applause back to the audience. All right, we go from that to the theater, and they take you back to the green room, and again, they give you exotic beverages to go ahead and cool yourself off. And I mean, just orange juice and banana, papaya, mango. Just delicious, delicious juices. They're absolutely wonderful. And the host comes along, one, two, three, go ahead and open your eyes. The host comes along, I'll be your host. Go ahead and open your eyes, go ahead and open your eyes. One, two, three, and sleep. Your host comes along. I'm going to give you some special instructions. The person I'm touching on the shoulder right now, it's going to be as if, there we go. We found equilibrium. You and the host are old friends. He comes to shake your hand and you're just a good old buddy of the host and you just won't let go shaking his hand. That's right. No, when I come back to you. Person I'm touching on the shoulder right now, after I get done shaking hands, talking with the first person, I'm going to come to you. And it's going to be as if my hand is diseased and you just don't want to touch. I'm going to try to shake your hand, you just won't let me. Person I'm touching on the shoulder right now, when I come to shake your hand, you're just going to be so giddy and excited with excitement that you just can't talk a straight sentence. It's just going to come out gibberish. You're going to be so excited, so excited. Person I'm touching on the shoulder right now, when I come to shake your hand, you're going to pull it away. You're going to trick me. You're going to make me look like an idiot. Every time I come to shake your hand, you're going to act like I just can't catch up with you, and it's probably going to be true. Person I'm touching on the shoulder right now, when I come to shake your hand, you're just going to come up with really weird questions. Doesn't have to have anything to do with anything, but you're just going to engage me with really weird, weird questions, maybe about my personal life, maybe about the universe, whatever it is, you're just going to ask weird questions. Person I'm touching on the shoulder right now, when I come to shake your hand, you're going to bark at me like a dog. You're going to bark at me like a dog. Anytime I come to shake your hand, you're just going to bark at me like a dog. Person I'm touching on the shoulder right now, you are a Martian interpreter. You speak Martian fluently, and you're going to help me interpret because the person I'm touching on the shoulder right now will speak to me in Martian, and you'll be the interpreter. So you can speak both Martian and English. You can only speak Martian. And the person I'm touching on the shoulder right now, you're just going to be rude. You can't use foul language or anything like that, but you really don't want anything to do with me or even to be here. That's just how rude you are. Ladies and gentlemen, give our participants a big round of applause. They bring you out on stage. One, two, three, open your eyes, open your eyes. So you're the group from Missouri. You're the group from, did I get the name right? Nodaway? North Nodaway? Is there like a South Nodaway and an East? And y'all just nod, apparently. Okay, very cool. Well, my name's Edward, and your name is? Keegan, it's good to meet you. What?
Well, thank you very much.
Keegan, what have you enjoyed on the resort so far?
Oh, just going to the beach, meeting people, and swimming.
Swimming, did you see the dolphins?
So I saw the dolphins.
That's absolutely wonderful. Okay, thank you very much. Keegan, what can you tell me about Nodaway?
Very small.
Very small. Okay, so like they say, you don't get out much, right?
No.
Okay, thank you very much. Keegan, we're going to be going live here pretty soon. I need to go and meet the rest of these people. Is that okay with you, Keegan? Okay, thank you very much, Keegan. No, Keegan, you have to leave. Thank you very much, Keegan. And you, young man, what is your name? What? You? Your name is you?
No, I don't know.
You don't want to touch my hand. Well, what's your name, sir?
Lucas.
We're happy to have you on the show tonight, Lucas. Thank you for joining us. And who do I have here? Michaela? Michaela, it's good to have you here. Have you had a fun time?
Uh-huh.
What's been your favorite part?
Everything.
Terrific. And who do I have here? And who do I have? Well, alrighty then. And who do I have here?
Kristen.
How's your stay been so far?
Fine.
Good.
What have you found interesting about our place?
Why does your sister always wear apple bottom jeans and boots?
Apple bottom jeans and what?
Boots with the fur.
Well, it's been a cold winter. And the apple-bottom jeans, I mean, that's just her body shape. What can you say? Thank you very much. Thank you for participating. And you, sir? And what's your name? Alrighty then. And your name, sir?
Cole.
Good to meet you, Cole. And your friend here? Her name is?
You don't.
Cheyenne.
Cheyenne, it's very good to meet you, Cheyenne.
Nice to meet you.
What is the proper way to greet somebody from Mars, by the way? What was that? Very good, very good. Very good. Thank you. How was your journey from Mars?
Hinte bit.
Do they have roller coasters on Mars?
Hinte bit.
Did she get to go on our roller coaster?
Yes.
Thank you, Cole, very much. And to say goodbye, how should I say? And sir, what's your name?
Why are you trying to touch me?
I'm just being friendly. I'm sorry if I offend you.
What is this?
This right here is a microphone.
Why are you trying to touch it with
me? I'm just trying to pick up your speech so that the other people can hear it. Fair enough. Give them all a big round of applause. One, two, three, and sleep. Give them a big round of applause.
The most amazing thing is going to happen. You feel like you are stuck to your chair. Like your butt and your thighs are stuck to the chair. You can't get out of your chair. Don't move your chair out of place, but you are stuck. Don't take my word for it. Check it out. And on the count of three, it's going to be like you're pinched on your right butt cheek. One, two, three. Where did that come from? One, two, three. And now you start to feel like you're being tickled. Tickled hard. Person, I'm done. Well, all of you, the previous suggestions are gone, so I can shake your hand normally. Person I'm touching on the shoulder right now, while you're sitting in your chair, you remember your name, but as soon as you get out of the chair, your name stays back with the chair. When you come back to the chair, you remember your name. First, I'm touching on the shoulder, the very same thing. In your chair, you remember your name. You absolutely know your name, but when you get out of the chair, you forget your name. One, two, three, go ahead, open your eyes, open your eyes. I don't know where that tickling came from, but tell you what, why don't one, two, three, you can stand up. Come on up here. Our audience is here, and your name is? I don't know. You don't have a name. When your mother wants to call you for supper, what does she say?
Hey, you.
Hey, you. Okay, go ahead, have a seat. Have a seat. Sir, let's see if we can get a little interview out of you up here. And your name is? Your name. When your mother wants to call you for supper, she says? Do what?
Come here.
Come here. And if you want to eat?
Come here.
Have a seat. Have a seat. Now, I don't want to be rude. You remember your name, right? Okay, come on up. And your name is?
I don't know.
But there you told me you remember. Do you remember your name now? I don't want to be rude. Oh, yeah, come on up. Your name, sir?
No.
You don't have a name. Have a seat. Give him a big round of applause. I hate to tell you all this, but this next skit is my absolute favorite skit. On the count of three, something amazing, truly amazing, is going to happen. One, two, three, boop, your belly button's gone. Your belly button is not there. You are flat. This is my favorite skit. I'm such a simple man. Your belly button is gone. Check it out. Don't take my word for it. Go ahead. Tell me what's going on here. Your belly button?
Just vanished.
Gone.
You okay?
What about your belly button?
Did you take it?
I'm trying to figure out why they're gone right now, making sure that they are. Your belly button?
I had it a second and ago, and it's gone, and I don't know where it went.
Yeah, I don't either. Check it out. What's going on down there?
Is this a magic trick?
It might be. I don't know.
I don't know. What the heck is going on here? All right.
All right, we're just going to go and go back to the beginning there. Well, tell you what, let me see what I can do here. If you would look under your chairs, there are binoculars down there. Pull those binoculars out. They have NASA on the side. Look into the audience. Look into the audience. And you may notice that some of the people in the audience don't look normal. They're aliens from other planets. They're friendly, they're not to do any harm. In fact, we're being invited into an intergalactic society, and they wanted to see how normal humans react to various stimulus. In fact, you even swam with two of the aliens this afternoon. Yes, you did. You swam with two of the aliens this afternoon. And so I think they've been playing these tricks on you. They've been tickling you and pinching you on your butt, and now they've stolen your belly buttons. If anybody sees an alien out in the audience, go ahead and raise your hand. Go ahead and raise your hand. What does your alien look like, sir?
Blue, two eyes.
Blue, two eyes, not how tall?
6'1". No mouth.
That's a very good description. What does your alien look like?
Green and short.
Green
and short. Like Toy Story. Like Toy Story.
Very good. Go ahead and sit back up here. Here you go. Reel him in
just like a bass. What's
your alien look like? It's purple. Purple. Okay. Tall, short, skin and fat.
Kind of chubby.
Kind of chubby. Hey, what does your alien look like?
Just like a human, except super duper ugly.
Super ugly human. Very good. What does your alien look like, sir?
Mine kind of looks like a Kevin Hart, but with Elvis Presley hair.
Kevin Hart the wrestler?
No, the comedy guy.
The comedy guy, Kevin Hart. I apologize with Elvis hair. Very good. And what does your alien look like?
Miss Dewhurst.
This is not Miss Dewhurst, but an alien.
Well, she smiles.
And Miss Dewhurst doesn't. Who's going to invite Miss Dewhurst to watch you do? All right. What does your alien look like, Miss?
It looks like a frog with clown hair.
Frog with clown hair. Very good. And your alien, sir, what does he look like?
It's a midget.
And your name is?
Aaron.
And your name is?
Cheyenne.
Very good. Give them both a big round of applause. I'll tell you what we're going to do here. Go ahead, open your eyes, look at me. Open your eyes, look at me. I have here the XP-3000 Space Modulator. This will send them back to their home planet. If they do not give us back our belly buttons, we're going to send them back to their home planet. It takes 1,000 years before they can come back. I need you to give them good reasons why we need belly buttons. I'm going to ask you to raise your hand. Why do we need belly buttons? Yes, sir.
How do we get food when we are in our mother's stomach?
If we don't have
belly buttons,
there you go. Yes, why do we need belly buttons?
We have to have something stinky to smell.
And belly buttons are usually
stinky.
Very good. Why else do we need belly buttons?
Where else do we get lint?
Where else do we get lint? And where would we get linseed oil, right?
Exactly.
Why do we need belly buttons?
Where else
will
we keep the
M&Ms? Where else will we keep our M&Ms? So, aliens out here in the audience, belly buttons are very, very important to us. I'm going to count to three, and I want you to yell out together at the count of three, we want our belly buttons back. On the count of three.
One, It's not yours.
What?
It's not yours. You've got a belly button there, but it is not yours. Check it out. What is wrong with your belly button? Tell me what's wrong with your belly button. Yes, sir.
I have a piercing.
It's ugly.
What's wrong with yours?
It's an Audi.
It doesn't have any lint.
No.
Mine, it kind of looks like a nipple. Like it's
different.
So
sorry.
It's different. Big Audi. Okay, she's getting there.
Big Audi looks like a nipple. All right. Whoa, good thing it didn't go off. Who else here can tell us what's wrong with your belly button? Anybody? Yes, ma'am.
It's too pale.
Too pale. Anybody else? Anybody else? Yes, ma'am.
It's too small.
Too small. Okay, here, sir.
Mine is wide.
One's too pale, one's just downright wide. Okay, you know, we may have found what's wrong with your belly button.
Mine's too tan.
Hers is too tan. How absolutely wonderful. All right. Aliens? If you do not give back the correct belly button this time, we're running out of time, I'm running out of patience, they're getting all stressed out. Look at you, give us your stressed face. Grounded for 3 weeks, give us that face. Count to three, or on the count of three, you know what to say. One, two, three. Check it out. It's yours. Give him a big round of applause. Very good. Very good. I think we got time for three. The person I'm touching on the shoulder right now. Person I'm touching on the shoulder right now. And person I'm touching on the shoulder right now, I want you to go into the audience. I want you to pick a friend. You are now elbow inspectors. Elbow inspectors. You know how some people can read the lumps on a person's head or on their hand? You will only pick out good characteristics based on their elbow. So go into the audience, you three, and go ahead and bring them back down on stage here. Check it out. Come on down, come on down. I said I wouldn't embarrass anybody who came on stage. I didn't say anything about people in the audience. Come on down, come on down. Come on down. Give them a big round of applause for sort of volunteering. Okay, now face that way so that everybody can see you how you're examining the elbows and examine those elbows. Examine those elbows. No pain, just examine them. When you're ready, just go ahead and look at me and nod your head. When you're ready, okay, one, two. We'll start on that end. You keep on until you're done. That's absolutely fine. We'll come down here. All right, very cool. And your name is?
Audrey.
Audrey, thank you for coming down today. And I've forgotten your name already. I apologize.
Lola.
Lola? Layla. Thank you, Layla. What can you tell her about us? What can you tell us about her elbow? Let me stand behind you guys here. Show the elbow to the audience.
And what can you tell about her from that elbow?
Well, she has been inactive because she has a scar. And I mean, I know she plays softball, so I mean, scar, so softball. And then it's kind of red, so like maybe she fell during basketball or something, or when we were playing earlier, I don't know.
Okay, very cool.
Anything about her personality at all? Show the audience again.
She's... She's a good friend. She's a nice person.
Very good, very good. Give them a big round of applause.
Go ahead and show his elbow to everybody here. And what can you tell us about his elbow?
Oh, I tell you what. If you were to elbow someone, it would be this elbow.
This is the one. Okay. Because.
Look at the thing. It's as big as my bicep. That's a decent sized elbow. Yeah.
So bicep to elbow ratio is very high.
Yes.
Okay, very cool. Anything else about his personality, man?
Oh, he's getting aged.
What do you mean by age?
He's getting crinkles. But...
Now, if he were to start to moisturize, do you think that would help?
So sweet. Oh, yeah.
Okay, so even for a man, moisturizing. Okay, cool, thank you. And down here, go ahead and show the audience her elbow, please. And what do you note about her elbow?
It means she's going to be 7 feet tall.
Like, right there. I see that. It's kind of like a ring.
Yep.
Okay.
And she's also going to be an Olympic ice skater because she dances. Right there.
Right there.
Yep.
Okay. Now this part in the middle, between the 7 foot tall and dancing skating, what's this middle part?
Nothing.
See, that's why I'm not the expert. Yep. Very cool. Kind of. And about her personality, what can we gain about her personality here?
She's nice. See?
Excellent. Thank you for coming up. We appreciate
it. Give them a big round of applause. Go ahead and take the train back to your spot. Very cool. Very cool. All right. I think we'll go ahead and finish up this way. Everybody look at me. You have been fantastic. You have been so wonderful tonight. All the applause has been for you. We're going to earn you some more applause here shortly, but I want you all to know just how absolutely wonderful you've been. Give yourselves a round of applause. First, I'm touching on the knee right now. When I say my name, which is Edward Wonder, you're going to jump up from wherever you are in the audience after I have everybody go back into the audience, and you are going to yell, "He's a fraud. I was never hypnotized." Whenever I say my name, Edward Wonder, you're going to yell, "He's a fraud. I was never hypnotized." Nod your head if that's acceptable to you. Very cool. First, I'm touching on the knee right now. Whenever I say North Nodaway, you're going to jump up and you're going to yell, "Go Mustangs." You don't like that? Why don't, I'm being serious, why don't you like that?
I'm from South Nodaway.
Oh. And what are the South Nodaways? The Longhorns. Very cool. All right. When I say North Nodaway, I want you to stand up and go down Mustangs, up Longhorn. No, that's not quite right either. Go Longhorns. Down Mustangs, go Longhorns. All right. And everybody else on stage is going to chant back, "Go Mustangs, down Longhorns." It'll be back and forth a couple of times, and I'll take control again. But you're gonna represent strong. Very cool. All right. Person I'm touching on the knee right now, whenever I say the word post-prom, I want you to just say what a wonderful time you had here, how fun, how exciting it was. But I want you to say it in Spanish, because I want to hear that, not in high school Spanish, like I had to try to spit out, but in your native language. Will you do that for me? Give me some kind of compliment about the show in Spanish and be enthusiastic about it when I say post-prom. Whenever I say that hypnotist, person I'm touching on the knee right now is going to jump up and start leading a chant, that hypnotist. And you're going to clap with that on those three syllables. So go ahead and do that now. That hypnotist. And you're going to get people to clap along with you and chant that with you. But after you've done it once, you're going to wait, because the person I'm touching on the knee right now is then going to respond back on Facebook, and you're going to clap on those three syllables, on Facebook, and you're going to get a call and response going back and forth, that hypnotist on Facebook, because it's very important. That's where I'm going to announce when the show is on YouTube for everybody to watch. That hypnotist on Facebook is where I'll announce it. Give everybody a big round of applause. Open your eyes. I've had a wonderful time here in, excuse me, North Nodaway.
Go Longhorns, down Mustangs!
Are you going to let me get away with that? I guess so. Represent. I'm going to send you back into the audience where the show is done. It's been fantastic. You have all been terrific. Give them a big round of applause for your music. And so go back, I'm going to put some music on, go back, join your friends, I'll answer any questions about hypnosis when I'm putting stuff away. But go ahead, stand up, go back to be with your friends. We'll get some music going here. Well, tell you what, we can wait on that. My name really is Edward Wonder.
He's a fraud! I was never hypnotized.
You were not hypnotized? You were one of the stars of the show, dude! You were what? Was he one of the stars of the show or not? Okay, well, but everybody's allowed their opinion. Everybody's allowed their opinion. I would never argue with a man with glasses. So, you know, we got that going for us. But I go by the stage name of that hypnotist.
That hypnotist!
That hypnotist!
Join them! Thank you very much, thank you very much. The reason why that is important is because probably about Tuesday, maybe Monday night, I'll be announcing where your show is on YouTube. And I want you and your family and friends to enjoy it. It is amazing. I will usually get about 1,200 to 1,400 video viewings from small audiences like this. It's the most amazing thing, so enjoy. And also, if I can ever come back and entertain for an organization that you're a part of, if you're gonna go off to college, remember me kindly. And the same thing for the adults. If you had fun tonight, and know I'll bring a different show the next time, that'll be great too. So, here we are at North Nodaway.
Go Longhorns, down Mustangs!
Guys, come on, represent
that. Go Mustangs, down Longhorns.
Go Longhorns, down Mustangs.
Go Mustangs, down Longhorns.
Go Longhorns, down Mustangs.
Okay, let's just agree to disagree. Let's just agree to disagree. Let's see, is there one other thing I should be saying? Oh yeah, the reason why we're here to begin with. Thank your post-prom committee.
Well, thank you.
Thank you.
Autograph. Very cool. If you have any questions about Hypnosis or the stage show, that's fine, but everybody who is on stage with me, look at me one more time, look at me one more time, and where you are, just for me, and sleep. In a moment, and sleep. In a moment, I'm going to have you stand up where you are with your eyes open, but I want to give you a present for being on stage. I want you to think about some way you can improve your life, some small but significant way you can improve your life. What I mean by that is this, not, I want to be a better person, that's much too big, but rather, of all the things you could do to be a better person, a better boyfriend or girlfriend, a better student, a better athlete, a better employee, a better sibling, whatever it is, one little thing that if you brought that into your life, you would improve. It will not be a compulsion. It will not get in the way of your regular life. It will be just a small thing that you remind yourself of and improve. And when you have that thing in place, you can then do the next thing. One, two, three, open your eyes, open your eyes. Go ahead and stand up where you are. Stand up where you are. I'm going to count from one to five. Have you fully emerged from hypnosis? All the post-hypnotic suggestions are now gone. I can say Edward Wonder without any argument. And you were starting the show. I can say post-prom. Not getting more compliments that way. I can say North Nodaway and not start a fight. So, all those post-hypnotic suggestions are gone except for the one I just gave you about that one little thing. When you have that one little thing, nod and smile. Nod and smile. Very cool. One, let that energy come up your body, all the way up your body, into your shoulders and down your arms, into your hands. Feel yourself stretching, letting that energy come in. Two, for the next couple, 3 days, even longer if you like, that energy that you have here and now is going to remind you about what that one little thing is. For the next 2 or 3 days, just let that little casual voice remind you how you do feel or behave. What you do and how you feel or how you behave is now a positive aspect of you. When you have that in place, then you can bring in the next thing after that. Three, even though we had just a few brief minutes doing hypnosis today, you find you feel wonderful. That energy fully coming in, your eyes opening wider and wider. Why, there you go. Very good. And welcome back. Did you have fun tonight? Yeah, very cool. Now, some people might have what's called hypnotic amnesia. If you do, that's fine. You can watch the video and see the show as a reminder. But even if you do remember the show, when you've got the time for years to come, go ahead and enjoy it. Someday I'll take it down, I'm sure, but not for a while. Four, let that energy fully come in. When it's time for you to go to sleep, you're going to sleep deeply and soundly. When it's time to wake up, you'll wake up refreshed. But for right now, feel yourself full of energy for the rest of your evening. And five, to one more big round of applause. If you have not fully emerged from hypnosis, your foot is stuck to the floor, and I'll come and attend to you in a little bit. If you have not fully emerged from hypnosis, all you can do is sit back down in your seat. Otherwise, who's the responsible party? I can give the microphone.